you feel the same. I feel like when I messed up the most is when God uses me the most. Now, I right, wrong, and different, I don't know, whatever. But sometimes that's just how I feel. Anybody know what I'm talking about? And sometimes you feel as if you're getting by with, so like, oh, I got by on that one. Like half my life, I feel like I got by on it. Wow. Like God didn't see. And he anointed us anyway. Because if I was God, I wouldn't use me. What about you? If I was God, if I wouldn't use me, the rest of you are certainly doomed. You got no chance. If I was God, if you were God, you wouldn't use you. No. I wouldn't use me. No. You're not getting by on God. It's the plan of God. We have to embrace our weakness. Accept it. But do something with it. What do you do with it? Cry out to God. Cry out to God. Adam added something to the image of God. He added weakness. We are the weakness of God. That's partly what makes God so beautiful. Look there in your commentary. It says, you know, it says that Adam added sin, if you like to hear that word, if you need to hear that word. He added sin, transgression. Oh, you're soft on sin. I'll throw sin at you all day if you like it then. You want it, I'll give it to you. Because sometimes we just see too much failure with that. We can't get beyond it, you know. So Adam added sin. He added weakness. God, therefore, he added something also then. God, therefore, also added something to the condition of mankind to bring perfection. What did he add? He added forgiveness. Now, I think God is showing something that's very powerful here, and I hope we understand it, and it changes our lives. What brings about perfection in life, I said it 1,000 times, I know, I got to say it again. It's not the absence of sin. God removing the sin from your life is not what's going to make you perfect. What's going to make you perfect is when you keep sinning and God adds forgiveness. So tomorrow you're going to sin and he's going to forgive. You're going to sin and forgive, which makes perfection. When Jesus Christ died upon the cross and he said, Scripture says he was the Lamb that took away the sins of the world. How did he take away the sins of the world? He forgave them. Because it seems as if since the time of the cross to now, it seems like in the earth realm, in the natural realm, nothing has changed. Like you and I still see sin, and that's why we're confused. Because we still see sin. So because we don't understand forgiveness, we're looking for Jesus Christ to come and do something about all the sin because we don't understand he already did. Because we don't understand forgiveness. I don't understand it for my life, and I know you don't understand it for your life. Because sin still beats me up and throws me down and makes me nothing. Because I don't understand forgiveness. But if I would accept the forgiveness of God, I would rise up in the power of Almighty God and be a son of God. Not because of the absence of sin, because of the presence of forgiveness. How did Jesus take care of the sin issue? He added forgiveness. Now, I could interchange sin and weakness if you want. God is not going to take the weakness out of your life. He's just going to add forgiveness. He's going to add strength. If you want to define sin, listen, all you guys might be holier than now, but as far as I'm concerned, as far as sin is concerned, how we traditionally define it, I sin every day. What is he doing on the altar? I sin every day, sometimes multiple times. Sometimes I'm in a sin rut. I mean, what? Sometimes I sin after sin after sin. What makes the difference in my life? Forgiveness. You might not forgive me, but that's okay. You're not God. It was up to you. You'd throw me in hell. That's the human. That's our human hearts, right? We throw people in hell. Come on, you and I throw people in hell all the time. Come on. How many people have you thrown in hell in your lifetime? Because of the sin that you see in their life. You see sin in their life, you say you're going to hell. Okay, whatever. Whatever. Because we don't understand forgiveness. That's why we think Jesus didn't take care of the sin issue, because we don't understand forgiveness. If you were to judge me in a natural term, and if I was to judge you in a natural term, you are not worthy. And I am not worthy. I have no right to enter these doors, and neither do you. What makes us great is forgiveness. What makes us great is God. The mortal realm will always contain sin and weakness, transgression. How do you bring about perfection? Forgiveness is the complete cycle of perfection. Forgiveness takes away the sin. Anytime you see sin anywhere, it's because you haven't added forgiveness. If you add forgiveness, you don't see sin. So wherever you see sin in this world, go back, add forgiveness, take care of it. And then there's no more sin. Then the words of Jesus are true. He was the Lamb that took away the sins of the world. And he has to remind me every day, he said, Mike, I forgive you. What sin are you talking about? I forgive you. Now go do what I called you to do. Okay. That's still a struggle, right? It's still a struggle. Mm-hmm. But the struggle's not a bad thing. Struggle's a good thing. Right? You guys all right? Okay. All right, so, you know, even as it goes down, then it says that Adam's one sin brought the penalty of death to many, while Christ freely takes away many sins and gives glorious life instead. The sin of this one man, Adam, caused death to be king over all, but all who will take God's gift of forgiveness and acquittal are kings of life because of this one man. The gift of God is greater than the transgression. As great as you think your transgression is, you must add forgiveness. The moment you add forgiveness to your transgression, you become great. Now, once again, I love the title of tonight. The title of tonight is The Weakness of God. What is the weakness of God? Humanity. We are the weakness of God. Adam introduced weakness into humanity. God introduced forgiveness into humanity. It's the completion of the cycle. The cycles will go on and go on and go on. So anytime you see sin in your life or you see sin in somebody else's life, you haven't completed the cycle. You have to add forgiveness, and then there is no more sin. It's based upon the work of Jesus Christ. It's a finished work. Jesus Christ is not coming back to do anything. He already did it. Our eyes just have to be opened up. I tell you, my life has changed in a moment, and so has yours. The moment I realize that I'm forgiven, how many times has your life been changed when you realize you're forgiven? Today, I realize I'm forgiven, boom, man, powerful again, right? Because of the work of the cross. And then that's a gift that you can give away, man. You can give that gift to people. Is that all right? Okay, everybody, that is the generations of Adam. God bless y'all. Why don't you stand? Pastor Dad, why don't you close?